The views and comments expressed on the following radio program by its hosts and their guests do not necessarily reflect the views of RMCOnAir.com or its affiliates. Listener discretion is advised. Hollywood, go. Go. Hey, Hollywood, go. Go.
Just where I'm at, well, let me tell you about it. I put my city on the map, but let me tell you about it. They try to say I can't come back, ain't let me tell you about it. Man, fuck them niggas, I come back, ain't let me tell you about it. I wanna tell you about it. Heads up, everybody run. Cole outside and he say he got a gun. Niggas like, man, that's what everybody said. Go and pop the trunk and everybody dead. Everybody scared of the nigga, aware that the nigga is better. All my bitches pick of the litter, never bitter. Niggas is fake, they anime. Me, I never hate, get cake like anime. Whoa, eat the cake, bitch, eat the damn cake. Fuck good, nigga, we the man great. Order domino, then she take off all the clothes. Nigga, you know how it go, made the piece of man wait. The best kept secret, even home, try to keep it, then I leak the damn tape. Rest in peace, any nigga won't be secret. Serving couldn't keep the man safe.
I said to the window, to the wall, my nigga ride when I come. Got bitches out of my mind. Fuck nigga black in my shine. I know the reason you feel the way. I know just who you want to be. So every day I think the man upstairs. That I ain't you and you ain't me. Get off my dick.
Them niggas, I come home and I don't tell nobody. They getting temporary dough and I don't tell nobody. Lord, will you tell me if I change? I won't tell nobody. I wanna go back to Jermaine and I don't tell nobody.
This is the part that the thugs skip.
Amen, amen, we back. You ready, yo, baby? Hey, where's my video, man?
Here you go. Video on the map.
Video.
Damn right, man.
Yeah, tell that girl get back on my dick.
I love this man.
You ain't got nobody on your dick.
Hey, dude,
boy.
Spinning this record, man.
J. Cole, I love him so much.
That's J. Cole.
He is making a nice comeback right now because he disappeared for a while.
Team White Skin.
Hey, that's right.
He drinking his skin milk, is back in effect. He feeling himself.
Momentarily.
We got a hater in the building.
Momentarily. Come on now. Not a hater, just sticking up for the darkies.
I'm mad he said darkies. Hit him with the round of applause for the darkies.
But he was proud of it, though. He owned it, though.
He did own it, though. I give him partial credit.
He did.
Partial credit. Hysterical.
Light skin issues. Only want to get partial credit.
Amy, you know.
I'm caramel latte.
Allegedly. Never mind. Let me stop.
I know. Be quiet.
It's reality radio, man.
I don't even know how to classify myself.
We done, man. We done. What y'all talking about? Right. Reality radio.
Yeah, we're gonna let that one go.
Happy Friday.
See, every time he put that light on me like that, he make me extra light skin. See, this is the bullshit I'm talking about. Hey, man, Generation U Radio, man. We're going to go around the room real quick. My name is Scott Taylor, a.k.a. Scotty Tripping. In the house, we got.
This is Melanie Eke. Happy Friday. Getting you started on a wonderful weekend.
You're damn right. I like your headphones.
Oh, you like
that? Yeah, last week your headphones looked funny. And in the house, we got. I mean, they
look. What's up, guys? Comedian Courtney Black in the building. TGIF.
DMV, baby.
F.
Damn right. And how's we got?
Yes, it's your boy William Basham, and I have a very serious announcement to make. My Seahawks is going to the Super Bowl, so yes, let it be known.
Hit him with the yeah.
Those of y'all who was like, yes,
we gonna get in this. We gonna get into that game, man, because that was a crazy game.
Oh yeah, damn. I'll be in Arizona.
By the way, that light makes me look good.
It
make you look good. Oh, sorry. And in the house, we got special guests in the building today. I'm excited about this one. Hit him with the round of applause as he jumps in. Hit him with the round of applause.
Hey everybody, how's it going? It's everybody's favorite white boy, RT, the most ignorant with the least pigment.
Hit him with the round of applause.
That's right. What's going on, people? I wasn't sure when to jump into the racial conversation. I was like double dutching over here. I was like, I'm glad you said darkies because I'm allowed to say that.
You're right. Hey man, and in the building we got a special guest from the Chi-Town.
Yes, sir.
J.Keene in the building. What's up? What's up?
Yeah, man. That's the homie right there, man. You know what I'm saying? Don't ask me how I know people, man. Hey, we got a special guest. And not a special guest. We got a young lady that's been gone for a little bit, and her voice was hoarse last week, so she couldn't do what she could.
Hey, everybody. It's the 502's finest.
Special assistant producer.
From the 502. It's Arin Patrice. Ready for this weekend, y'all.
502's finest.
Yeah. 502. Last week, she sounded like, yeah, how's everybody doing?
All right.
I did.
Keep it real.
Damn. Hey, man, we got a special DJ in the building. DJ Orion in the on the ones
welcome,
and twos.
Welcome.
Hit him with the round. Matter of fact, go ahead and spin up, man. Go ahead and spin up.
Thanks
yeah.
for coming through,
yeah.
Orion.
We appreciate having you out here, man.
He got a full DJ
right.
bar too.
Damn right, man.
And he got turntables, turntables to spin drinks out and everything.
You got a bar under there.
Right.
Hey, man, this Generation U Radio, man, Reality Radio, Fridays at 6 o'clock on RMC On Air, man. If you get a chance, check us out. Make sure to subscribe to our YouTube channel at Gen U Radio. Twitter, IG, the same thing, man. We'll be right back after this break.
Yep. OEO, man, we really with the shits, boy. Yeah. Really with the shits. I should probably sign a hit, boy, because I got all the hits, boy. Fuck all that Drake, you got to chill shit. I be on my little mouse drill shit. Fuck all that rap to pay your bill shit. Yeah, I'm on some rappers, pay my bills shit. All up on TV, I thought it made me richer. Wasn't paying me enough, I needed something quicker. So now I'm all in Nico basement, putting working on the phones. Either that or drive the money mark to make the pickups. Man, it's 2008, I'm trying to paint the picture. Comeback season in the works and now I'm thinking bigger. I got 40 in the studio, every night, late night. Gotta watch that shit, don't wanna make them sicker. That's my nigga, oh lord. Got a whole lot to show for it. I mean, we could really get it, we could go for it. I'm just here for the bucks and the billies, nigga. Don't make me kill one of the ghosts for it. I run this shit, they like, go for us. Run for us, run for us, go for us. Yeah, I mean, y'all already wrote for us. Damn, nigga, what's one more quote for us? Oh, Lord, who else sounding like this? They ain't made me what I am, they just found me like this. I was ready. Fuck that, I been ready since my dad used to tell me he would come into the house to get me. He ain't show up. Valuable lesson, man, I had to grow up. That's why I never ask for help. I do it for you niggas and do it for myself. I go 0 to 100, nigga, real quick.
Hey, man. I try to real quick.
Hey, man.
Hey, man.
It's
real
fast.
It's pretty fast. Ice Cream Rappers is coming up. 0 to 100, real quick.
I don't want
to
hear it. I don't want to hear it.
Real quick.
Hey, man, it's the Hollywood Show on Generation U Radio, baby.
Yes, it is. Because, Scotty, we know. Sometimes
you get Hollywood, bro.
I get Hollywood.
Scotty be tripping.
Hollywood on us.
Man, I stay on Crenshaw, baby. Hit me with the round of applause because I keep it here. I keep
Hollywood
it
South.
Yeah, you don't know what
that's Hollywood.
But hold on, though. Hollywood is a state of mind, though. There are a lot of people who don't stay in Hollywood.
I'm
place,
successful. That's
Hollywood
I know that. I'm successful in my mind.
I'm not talking
Hollywood
about clubs. You.
She went in my own radical way.
Right.
I'm just saying
now,
though.
Now, this is a state of mind.
Right.
But I'm saying as in we get into own. The topic, though.
Melanie, you about the most Hollywood motherfucker in the room right now.
Watch out.
Look at you.
She threw her pin.
Look at you. With your.
That's that Basketball Wives. You got to stop watching Basketball Wives.
Look at my jewelry.
I can't defend myself. That's Basketball Wives.
This is my suit. I got rubber bands, baby. Hey, man.
No, I do have a question. I do have a question for you guys, though. Does anybody are there any people who actually have a right to be Hollywood, though? Like, I mean, some people maybe earn the right to be Hollywood.
You Jewish?
How do you earn the right to just be Hollywood?
What is Hollywood?
Hollywood, in my opinion, I'm sorry, is like stuck up shunning people because you think you got more than everyone else.
Yeah, you think you're better.
That's my opinion. You might have something different.
That's how you took it, but does that mean that's what they meant?
I take it, at least.
So are you emotional? Is that why you take things that way?
Am I emotional? Hey, yo, man, why you being Hollywood, dog? You don't call me no more, man.
Walking on eggshells.
Nah, man.
No, Will, let me ask you something, though. But, like, if there's somebody who really has accomplished some things, you know, they're in the industry, so they may dress nice and they may have their head up high because they deserve their success.
They're feeling themselves.
But you may take them as being Hollywood, though.
Yeah.
So is
it's not.
Possible?
That's it's not even that. It's more about the attitude they present. You can get your money. You can do your thing and still be a cool person.
Okay.
It's when I come up to you and I'm like, hey, you know what I'm saying? We've been good friends, and you're like, oh. Yeah.
Security. Like, get him off me.
How you gonna call security on me? Like, nigga, I live with you.
That's why I get.
Who is this light skinned guy? And no, I don't want to listen to his album.
Yeah. Yeah. None of y'all. I don't know you.
Security.
I do not want to see any dance moves. Get him away from me.
Exactly.
Who is this light-skinned guy?
You can't do that.
Team light-skinned, I guess.
Dance moves.
So Will, I take it that you've had some personal experiences.
I know. Right?
You seen somebody in your life got love.
Yeah.
Nah, but I'll put you on blast if you get Hollywood with me real quick.
I know that's right.
So, real quick.
But you know, like, define what you think is really Hollywood. I mean, you know, everybody thinks something different.
Yeah.
It
just depends on the person, really. You know what I mean? It could be a bride who just wear her weave the way she wear it, and she just,
yeah,
you know what I mean?
She got the
Brazilian. You know, they want the Brazilian, the Yaki, and all that shit. Get your ass out of here.
Right.
You keep it real. You got another motherfucking hair on your head.
Hey,
you keep it real.
You think that's how
she got top
somewhat?
No, but they do say in L.A. that people, you know, it's so many transplants.
Yeah.
That people have come here and changed and become Hollywood. Yeah. They say that.
Same with the Army, man. Same with the Army.
The Army went Hollywood?
I know, right? Yeah. The Army. Well, since they started making
the new uniforms are fabulous. They got rhinestones on them.
Ain't no ass tail no more. It's a whole different Army now. You know, it's bullshit.
I know the Army got Timberland boots.
Nah, people be coming from all sorts of cities and going to the Army and act like,
oh yeah,
I'm saying?
Right.
Like they run shit.
Okay, but do you think that people have to prepare a certain image? Like, I moved to LA. I'm not saying I'm saying I'm somebody who moved to LA and I see that everybody looks a certain way, talks a certain way, acts a certain way. In order for me to even get noticed, you feel like you're naturally gonna have to play that role.
What's that? Hanging with the
Joneses? Somewhat,
Hanging with the Joneses.
Or fake it till you make it,
fake it till you make it.
I think you're gonna get noticed if you really got talent. Like, yo, you shouldn't be that worried. I don't get worried. I don't ever think of people being Hollywood. Like, if people treat me fucked up, I might get mad, but I'm not gonna be like, oh, they Hollywood, because I look at it like I got my own talent. I'm not really jealous of what they're doing.
Right.
You know what I'm saying?
You're securing yourself.
It depends where you come from too. You know what I'm saying? Because in Chicago, a lot of motherfuckers out here is Hollywood to me, just how they walk. And,
everybody.
Straight up. You know what I'm saying? Yeah, it's a lot. I be looking like, what the fuck wrong with this? You ain't finna get discovered, bitch. She just struggling shit.
Just because you in Hollywood don't mean
your ass jiggling like that. What the fuck are you crossing the street, bitch? You are on Slauson. Your ass is jiggling like that on Slauson?
City.
You go to that subway, man. They Hollywood in that subway, man.
Right.
You know what I'm saying?
Fuck with your hood.
Exactly.
Melanie get mad every time I mention Culver City and some bullshit.
What's wrong with Culver City? Culver City is probably one of the least Hollywood cities in LA, just FYI. So if you want to see some.
I don't know.
She's trying to stand up for us. Deal with the disclaimer real quick, because that's allegedly.
The comments expressed on the following radio program.
We got love for Culver City, too. I'm just joking. Hey, man.
I'm mild.
But nah, like, I look at it like this, man. If you want to come up, what's the difference between you acting Hollywood and the people around you looking at you like, oh, I could get something off this motherfucker now. So now they start calling you. Like, I feel like some people it might be the opposite. Am I wrong?
Mm.
RT, let's ask RT real quick.
You gotta be true to yourself. I mean, you can't control the other people around you.
Right.
If they want to act Hollywood for you and then get you things that Hollywood offers, then
that's on them.
That's what managers and agents, you know,
they
can act Hollywood.
Let me ask you this:
they can sell you as Hollywood.
You're gonna get that.
Work for you.
That comes with the territory. You gonna get that. You gonna get that.
But check it out, man. Let me ask you a question.
Because
I don't want to say too much about your credits, because I'll let you do that yourself. Can I? Is cool if I do that?
No. I mean, say whatever, but
this is RT from the Foxhole, man. I met this dude when he was in Reach Around Radio, and he works with some of the elite people, the guys that I came from. But let me ask you this, man. As you've been rising, have you noticed the people around you start looking at you like a target, or like, oh, well, they want something, or do you feel like, because I know you keep it real.
Look, you get all types of people. And
you
the
get
most
pussy, though, right?
Yes, the pussy gets better. Yes.
That's true.
Really?
Yes. Got to get my money game right now.
I don't know what to hit him with. Never mind.
Right.
I want to say the disclaimer.
I would hope so.
I don't fuck girls that work at fast food restaurants no more.
Get your quality game.
I'm acting Hollywood.
They still will.
No more McDonald's.
No more Walmart girls.
He moved up to Red Lobster.
Nothing past Wilshire. Nothing past Wilshire.
It's having standards.
Unless you got a fat burger. Oh, yeah.
You good there.
But that's exactly what I'm saying, though. Just having standards make you Hollywood. That's what I'm saying. Just because I have a certain standard for myself, all of a sudden I'm Hollywood?
That's true.
No, it's just how you treat people. And you know, like y'all were saying earlier, kind of being, you know, just being shunned. Like if somebody returned, you know, if y'all were friends, right, and all of a sudden one person succeeded, and now they don't return your phone call anymore, that's acting Hollywood.
There you go.
Yeah.
That ain't shit. Hollywood is just a new...
What if he was busy? You know what I'm saying?
Busy. Yeah, for the last 10 years.
I ain't been able to hit you up in a decade.
You know, I just had bills and shit that was just piling up.
Saying Hollywood is the new word for hater.
You know what I'm saying? You don't say, oh, he a hater no more. You be like, oh, he Hollywood. It's the same shit. You know what I'm saying? We just moved to 2015, so they say Hollywood now. It's the same shit.
Now, let's get back into this, though, man. So now you're working at Foxhole now. You know what I'm saying? Hit him with a round of applause for getting there, because I was fucking happy for you when I found out about
it. Yeah, we're doing a morning show on Foxhole every morning.
Congratulations on that. You just got that. You just went official, right?
Thank you. That's on 96 on Sirius. If you got Sirius XM, it's 96.
And for those that don't know, that's where this a lot of what we do came from my experience working with the Foxhole, because that's how I started in radio.
Yeah, for sure.
You know? And I met you at Reach Around Radio, man. Yep, I remember. Dude, man. I remember Vegas, man. It gets crazy. Don't worry about our life. Reality radio, baby. But like,
smoking and rapping.
Let's talk about
Vegas. You feel like people got a target on your back now that you blowing up, man.
Let me ask him. Say his little credits. I mean, not little credits. I'm
sorry. Oh, why my credits got to be little?
She's
a little college degree.
Hilarious.
She gave you a discredit.
Scott even tried to ask him this question for the past 10 minutes.
Right,
oh,
man. Y'all niggas ain't shit right now. I was trying not to say the word, but
now you know how I feel. Now you know how it's in the black. But what I'm trying to say, before you get into that, go ahead and say his credits, because nobody's knowing what you're talking about.
You right. That's what's you up. Right. Yeah, yeah.
You know, so, he's been on Real Hustle.
Hey, hold on. What was that?
I keep my mouth closed about things light. With their stuff for a reason, because, you know, like, I like...
But it's a topic. The topic is
I keep my mouth... Go ahead.
You've been on Real Husbands of Hollywood, so you're with all those people. Yep. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean? So that's a whole Kevin Hart thing.
Yeah, that was a lot of fun.
It ought to be some good sex coming with that. Conan O'Brien, you did Conan.
I see
what
your
mind
is.
You got the white girls, too. Same good sex.
Shout out to diversity.
Everything goes back to sex.
Yeah, very diverse.
I know, right?
Yeah.
Back to sex.
I'm all about diversity and unity. Yeah.
Showtime, Comedy Central.
You're one under the covers.
You know what? You are the American Idol. Regardless of what they say.
I won.
You are the American Idol.
But he really is doing it. We're not just saying it. So I just want people to know that he really you're in those circles.
Diversity under the covers.
So you're in those circles where, the vultures start coming out a little bit.
Oh, yeah.
Or do they?
They definitely do. I mean, that's what this town is. This town is built on people taking advantage of what other people have built.
Now, but Foxhole's big, man.
And we're hoping big things for it. I mean, it's a big opportunity, and we're gonna do our best to make it funny. I mean, I'm not a morning person, so it's gonna be interesting.
It's gonna be hard. Right? Shout out to Speedy real quick.
Shout out to Speedy. And it's the rollout morning show. We start February 2nd. It's the day after the Super Bowl. February 2nd.
Nice.
That comes on 8 a.m. West Coast.
For all the Foxhole fans, it's been waiting for the Foxhole to come back, man.
Yeah, it's back.
And your team, you guys been doing it just like once a week.
We've been doing every Wednesday, and I think we have our last show this Wednesday, and then we're starting February 2nd.
That's hot. Super Bowl. Congrats. Yeah.
Big man. Congrats, man.
Mm-hmm. Get that right.
Yeah.
Hey, we're going to go. Hey, cue my music up real quick, man. We're going to go ahead and get this together real quick, man. It's a Generation U radio show,
Sorry,
man.
Scotty.
What is it, a freestyle break? Are we freestyling?
Yeah, we're going to turn the music up real quick. We got DJ Orion on the ones and twos. Go ahead and spin something for me real quick. Matter of fact, man, how you doing, dog? You got any shows coming up? Let's get in there real quick. Just yell. You got your mic?
A couple of EDM projects, dance music, and hip-hop.
They can't hear you.
Someone translate for him.
Hi. Y'all speaking English in here?
Sign language.
Can you hear me now?
He has some projects.
Yeah, so anyways... my name is DJ Orion with the Orion Music Production, and
keep his music.
I'm actually working on a few projects right now, a few dance projects and hip hop projects. So look out for me.
I'll be dancing.
Yeah, still at your boy.
Yeah, man. It's the Hollywood Show on Generation U Radio, man. We're gonna be right back after this break. RMC on air, 6 o'clock Fridays. Let's go.
Yes, sir.
Like a hollow point headed for your dome. Take a couple steps, turn around in its own. Couldn't withstand the murderous mental. I subdue and then take two to your temple. When I cause all the cause from what's written, niggas collapsing when the straps is spitting. Look, this is how it's done, nigga. I grab my strap, your best run, nigga. I give the fuck, corrupts the kingpin of the click. Then it was G with the biggest dick.
Shit, a motherfucker better recognize. With the twist of my wrist like OJ, you won't die. I snack on motherfuckers like a bone. Wanna be the shit upon the microphone ever since I was born. Not to ever love a bitch. Learn game after game. That's why we are the best. Motherfuckers be gangsta styles minute after minute. But soon as you did it, I smelled the nigga shit. Now what would you do?
What you do?
If you could fuck with me or my crew.
But you can't, so don't even think about stepping in the motherfucking house.
What would you do?
What you do?
If you could fuck with me or my crew.
But you can't, so don't even think about stepping in the motherfucking house.
Bitch, butterfly all day while I steady make my pay every single day in the LBC. Cruising through the east side, me and Lil' Style in the back of a green 6-4 busting freestyle.
There's no escape, give me the papers in the tape case. How much money could a nigga make in one place? The review ain't shit new. You stupid motherfuckers can't fuck with my crew.
I see all these niggas trying to get with my kinfolk. Get so many busters on the west coast.
and none to say the least. I see a few trick ass niggas laying low on the East Coast. And the question is asked, do you wanna rap, scrap or blast, cause that nigga dad? I'll be the first one to hit him. Oh yeah, fuck BG, knock out and every nigga down with him. Cause I'm a natural born killer, and I still a hat, motherfucker, cause it's like that.
Now what would you tell if you come up with me or my crew?
It's so many motherfuckers that I can include, who's quick to blast motherfuckers in a feud. It doesn't make a difference.
While I put my headphones on, plug my shit.
That song came on in the 90s.
So laid back.
That's that West Coast.
That shit's so laid back. You just be. Ugh. See why they say gangsta don't dance, they book.
Yeah. Man, we got J.Keene in the building from the Chi Town.
I'm here.
Yeah.
We got RT in the building.
That's right.
From Atlanta.
That's right.
ATL shot. What up, folks?
I feel hard when that song comes on.
What that do, folks?
Turn that music up, man. I want to rock with that.
Holla at your boy.
And picture that nigga dance.
All right, we hey, man, it's the Hollywood Show, man. Shout out to DJ Orion on the ones and twos, man. We appreciate you.
Yes, DJ Orion. Thank you.
Hey, man, well, I want to get into these interviews real quick, but I want to start with J.Keene, man.
Yes, sir.
You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. So we met out in the streets, man, out here in L.A.
Yeah.
Gangsta.
What, in the streets. Yeah, tell the people. Yeah, and I didn't know y'all knew each other.
Hot dog stand.
Hell yeah. Okay,
this nigga at the taco shop. Like, yeah.
The lady with the... By that lady with
the... A chicken, nigga.
That lady had them churros.
Yeah.
Right over there.
It was actually the corn, you know.
Yeah, we let it. Corn. We met at the corner of churro and burrito.
He put me on game when he got the extra mayonnaise on the corn. He was like, flop, flop, flop. I'm like, oh, yeah.
That Chipotle.
Yeah.
You know,
oh, that dude's real. Look at that mayonnaise,
chili sauce.
That dude's real.
Yeah. You remember when E-40 called and he was talking about that white sauce?
Yeah.
That shit was hilarious.
That white sauce. That sounds nasty.
Damn, dog. Hey, yo, so.
All up in your esophagus. Ooh.
Ooh. All right. Okay.
And I remember that joke went viral when you was doing the gorilla joke with old boy.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
I had to.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
I defend my friends.
You came to my defense.
Yeah, that was good.
I'm going memory lane today.
I defend my friends. That's my peoples, man.
Yeah, yeah. Let's get into this. I appreciate that, Scotty.
You know, Jay, you know what I mean? What you got going on? I didn't even know y'all knew each other, man.
Well, I don't know him.
I don't know him either.
I know y'all.
I don't know you. What show is this?
I don't know y'all.
It's I don't know you.
What the hell is a generation? You know, I don't even know that.
Breaker. Yeah, I see you in the trenches. Yeah,
you know, Hollywood.
Yeah, you know. No, actually, that wasn't Hollywood. You know what I mean? We like, yeah, we know each other. We comedians. Yeah,
yeah, yeah.
We like, yeah, I'm gonna see if this motherfucker funny.
This nigga got the brightest red shirt on I ever seen in my life. Right. That shit is bright than a motherfucker. We had to turn the lights down.
That's like, fire engine red.
Dark skin. It's like
fire.
Chocolate covered strawberry.
Chocolate covered strawberry.
Yes, sir.
Sweet and delicious.
So would you say your style is more L.A. or more Chicago? How long have you even been out here?
I've been out here like 6 years. I'm so Chicago.
Okay.
Yeah.
So Chicago.
Yeah, I mean, L.A. cool, but y'all got y'all own thing. You know what I mean?
So you started your comedy in Chicago?
I started my comedy shit when I was born, really.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
You know,
where'd you hit your first stage?
Shout out to the Hollywood show. Damn.
I know, right?
Out here?
Right.
Out here?
I was born.
Out here?
Yeah.
Okay.
On my birthday, actually.
And you, nice. Say you stayed in St. Louis.
Yeah, I was in the Lou for a minute.
All right.
I went to college out there.
All right.
Okay.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? So what you got coming up, man? You got any shows coming up, anything?
Shit, man. I don't know. I took a break from comedy, man. You know, I've been writing, but as far as like getting up on the stage, I kind of took a break because I felt disrespected, man. You know, last time I did a set, dude was like, man, it's like a slow night. You know, we ain't got no money, but I'm going to pay you in chicken. And I was like.
fried or baked, man.
You serious?
Depending on how they cook it.
He was like, I got the 6-piece. He's like, you know what? I'm going to throw 2 extra wings in there. And I got the cheese fries for you. And this nigga was not playing. He was a black dude. I was like, nigga, you.
Obviously.
I was going to say
this
you.
This is in L.A.?
Hey, man, is it Tabasco? Tabasco sauce or.
That's the game.
He had Red Rooster. But still, I was like, nah, nigga. I didn't tell these jokes. Nuh-uh.
All right, see, I'm sure you've gotten paid, and so we've all.
Oh, well, I was about to say, that's a good night. They gave you actually pieces of chicken.
They gave you fried chicken, and you were mad? That's how I know you came to L.A.
A live chicken to go home and kill.
He was like, damn, you gave me fried chicken. You could at least get me back on.
I mean, I did a show for a tender before. I did one tender I got. No sauce, just a la carte.
Would you take it?
Yeah, one tender, that's it.
Speaking of Hollywood, man, you know what I'm saying? So what's it? What you guys got coming up with the Foxhole outside of that? You guys got any?
I think they're doing an event at the Super Bowl, and we're supposed to go to the All-Star game, which I'm looking forward to. That's in New York, I think, this year.
Yeah,
so
it is.
It'd be fun to go to New York.
To make that trip.
You know, and
Have you been around All-Star weekend before?
No, never done it. Oh. So
it's a lot of ratchetness. So yeah, I was about to say. Yeah.
Get the disclaimer for All-Star weekend.
It's a disclaimer.
There's a reason I'm going.
He's from Atlanta. It's like Freaknik.
How's Melanie know? Is she a pro? How you know?
It was in L.A.
I'm ready to look at the host role. I want mine. I'm gonna get my European sports jersey on.
Hey, I'm gonna have his Larry Bird jersey on.
Benjamin jersey. Dirk Nowitzki.
Dirk Nowitzki.
I'll put on some stilts.
Yeah, man, the thoughts are getting ready already.
I say it's a very thoughtful event.
They already ready.
They're in
the gym right now.
They're already there.
Gym right now.
Hair online has been ordered.
Already there.
Deposit has been placed on the hair.
They don't even go to the gym no more. They wear that shit around their waist that suck all the shit in.
Lazy shit.
Like, you could just build your ass, but you get the ass implants. Right. Put the disclaimer on ass implants, man.
It's so disproportionate.
Yeah.
He was talking about abs. But
I'm talking about
abs.
Spanks
for the memory.
All ladies out there, earn your ass.
I guess you're still been adding to our Hollywood list. You're saying fake.
That's a
big
part.
Fake body parts.
Fake body parts.
What can we go get?
Hey, dudes be doing it, though. Dudes be getting fake abs. They got implant abs.
Give me the 300. I want the 300.
I want 300 abs.
They sure do. They sure do.
It looks like you flexing at all times.
I'll pay for that.
Do the fake abs come with a loincloth? Because if I had abs, I just wear a loincloth.
Both of you guys having played many stages in L.A. or performed in many stages.
Hey, hit my music for me, man.
What would you say is the most Hollywood club in L.A. or the Hollywood venue?
I didn't even change it so quickly. I mean, it's
just venues. Oh,
The Laugh Factory on Sunset is always packed with celebrities. You always see celebrities up in
Laugh
there.
Laugh Factory is a little, Do you feel
inside
like
jokes.
The crowd is a little... Okay, is it possible for a crowd to be Hollywood? You know, like
oh,
a crowd
yeah,
is like...
Oh, yeah,
without
doubt. They can get too bougie.
Yeah, like, you know, that was funny.
Now, you better really make me laugh.
They sit right up in the front,
too. That's how rap fans like to
tag your ass, bitch.
I don't got to laugh.
Yeah, they don't want to laugh too hard because they face lift might bust.
Their
fake ass might just split.
Might fall out.
They wear that basketball wife shit around their waist.
He keep calling it the basketball wife shit.
Because they ruin black women. Fucking show, man.
Hey, man, we going to get this shit.
It's personal.
Stop it.
It is personal.
Stop it. Everybody stop. We going to get this bullshit together real quick. It's DJ Orion in the building real quick. You know what I'm saying? Generation U Radio, man. Y'all want to take it out? Go ahead and take it out, Will. Take it out.
He don't know what to do.
He don't know what to do. Courtney, go ahead and take it out.
What's up, you guys? Thanks for tuning in. We'll be back. About 2 seconds, 2 and 2. That's that.
We gonna work on it. We gonna Generation U Radio, man. We'll be right back after this break. Cut that shit.
Turn my music high, 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 high,
oh yeah, and keep that music going. I like that. I like that energy.
I want to get into a kind of interview with our guests. Can we do that?
Let's do that. Let's do that because we got some big guests in the building today. Courtney, I want you to take the lead on that. Go ahead and take
that. Good. Thank you. So we already said that RT is from Atlanta. How long have you been doing comedy, RT?
A long time, man. Like your boy said, from the womb. No, but the first time I got on stage was in 96.
Nice. Vet. That's a vet.
Yeah, that's a long time ago. Yeah, I was, how old was I, 19 or 20 or some shit?
18 years.
And yeah, it's a long ass time. But, you know, you don't get work early because, you know, your first time you go up, you're like, what the fuck am I doing? And then so it takes a while for somebody to be like, yeah, I will pay you money to make people laugh.
So did you ever have like a regular career path and then go off to comedy?
No. I always kind of was entertaining. I was in a band in high school and then a band out of high school. And then I was like, I'm not cool enough to do music. So I'm like,
right.
He wanted to be a rapper.
Yeah, I did want to be a rapper, but I was like, I don't have a rap. I don't have a hit. Eminem. But I don't have a good rap name. So I'm like, you know what? I'm just not, you know. I love rapping, but man, I just felt like comedy was the way.
But
man,
he from Atlanta, you know what I'm saying? That's the hobby. Hey, you know what? Matter of fact,
he sings in his act, so he does that.
Yeah, I do all types of stuff: music and R&B, rapping, and voices, everything. I try to be funny.
You're trying to be funny?
Yeah, trying to be funny.
What's it like the first time you get on stage?
He's very funny.
Man, nervous. I was nervous as fuck. I was nervous. I had to be drunk because I was just like, I felt like my heart was going to beat out of my chest.
Isn't it crazy? You feel like you're
hurting. And I just felt like I was going to just die or something. So I was like, I needed something to take the edge off. So.
And how did you do? Because usually when you drink, you kind of mess up.
Yeah, you start slurring and stuff. But I was very just amped and focused. So I think my adrenaline was outweighing the alcohol.
Good.
That's what it was like. That's what it was like interning for. I was nervous.
Yeah, you get nervous.
I was
sometimes.
So nervous being around them dudes because I really respected them.
Yeah, and it's nervous being just in front of people that are just, I mean, 300 people that you're trying to make laugh.
Exactly.
And, you know, and, you
that's
know.
Real talk. I'm going to keep it 100.
Well, what kind of shows do you have coming up?
I got a show Wednesday. I'm doing Inside Jokes at for ADD. It's a Russell Simmons show.
Nice. And you just did the Shaq All-Star Showcase,
yeah, Shaq
right?
All-Star
nice.
Showcase. And, yeah, all types of stuff, man. So
those ADD shows, to is that mm-hmm. new, the live shows? Because I know it started with the
it's
YouTube channel.
Yeah, well, so yeah, it's part of that. Part of that. And, yeah,
okay.
It's a live show for that. Yeah,
they
still got the YouTube channel and all that. Yeah.
Okay.
A lot of celebrities come through there. Yeah.
Justin Bieber was there on Wednesday.
Yeah, Justin Bieber was there.
Trying to see some celebs, you go there. On Wednesday.
Oh. Mayweather though.
I don't want to see him.
Well, you know, that's just the first one that came to mind. But
yeah, a bunch of
I was
them
about guys. To say, Courtney, Bieber, you don't Bieber. Strike me as a Justin Bieber fan. I
got Bieber fever.
Did you see that underwear?
He's a believer.
Bieber fever.
He was cute. No. That's a weird Calvin Klein commercial.
Oh, fake abs. Those are fake abs.
Those are the fake
He's ones. So Hollywood.
Bieber's so Hollywood.
So Hollywood.
I think that comedians are the least Hollywood of the celebrities.
No, they get Hollywood.
Hollywood. It depends on which ones.
I met some Hollywood ones.
I was trying to throw a compliment to the comedy world, but never mind.
No, I'm
if you see a comedian with a thick mustache and a sweater vest. You know he's going to be Hollywood.
Hilarious.
What a
mess.
No,
that's an inside
I mean,
joke. That's it.
You meet everybody, and it's like you. Some of the people are stuck up and some aren't, but some kind of, you know, they have to act. I don't even want to say Hollywood, but some people are so big that they can't talk to everybody.
Right.
I mean,
it's called professional after a certain.
Right. I mean,
you realize that too. You know that, you know.
But people get emotional. Sometimes people get emotional and take that as Hollywood when that motherfucker. About his business. That's it.
Yeah, yeah. And like you got to think about it from their perspective too. It's like, you know, like in my limited experience of people, you know, just seeing me or whatever. It's like, you know, you'll still get bothered while you're eating. You know, you're like literally, you're like have a piece of food in your mouth. Yeah. Hey, I don't mean to bother you, but you're like motherfucker, I'm eating. There's a food is entering my mouth hole
all the time, especially when I wear glasses. They were like that.
So it's just
T-Pain.
Right.
It's T-Pain.
I'm like, not T-Pain. T.
With a round of applause. That nigga like, do look like T-Pain.
I'm like, it's not. I'm not that nigga.
J.Keene, moving on to you. You said you actually did start, you know, young also. You've always been a funny cat. But did you go to school, college, and pursue something else and come back to comedy? Or
Yeah.
What
most
was your
definitely.
Journey like?
After I graduated high school, I went to college. I got a degree in sociology. I work currently right now with the autistic population.
Oh, nice.
Okay.
Yeah, I got experience working with, like, troubled teenagers and, like, treatment facilities, things like that. Like, you know, I'm really into teens. That's why I moved out here, to open up a treatment facility for troubled teens and to help them. Then the recession came, and it was like, that shit was out the window.
Yeah, and they're like, fuck these teens.
Yeah.
Right. It's money.
So the entertainment thing was actually your second choice.
Maybe like 30 or 40. I was doing security for a while. And I get crushing heads.
Because everybody comes out here to get into the industry. So something else actually brought you out here, and then you found the industry.
Yeah,
so that's a great path. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Very.
And what do you think you want to take your career? Where do you think?
What I want to do ultimately is I want to get my master's, and I want to open up my own practice, and I want to have an intervention with comedy and counseling as my intervention.
Nice, that's, you know, great. I like that.
That's my 5-year goal.
Nice.
5 years.
I know, that's right. So,
how about you, RT? I didn't ask you that. What do you think you want to take?
Sorry, I was just in my head, I was envisioning the comedy counseling. I was just
like,
that could actually work.
Especially when it's a serious topic.
Because laughter is healing. You know what I mean?
Like, don't kill yourself. Put down that gun. Don't kill yourself. Put down that gun.
Nah, maybe they might need to kill themselves.
They do.
Yeah,
cracking jokes.
I was actually just reading an article that says that laughing contributes to happiness.
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
Oh, without a doubt.
It does.
That's why I respect.
You know how much pussy comedians get? Not me, but other comedians. Because you can make a young lady laugh.
Yeah, that's the way.
It's like, yes, it makes me happy, all right.
Yes, it's that much easier. Like,
you don't make her laugh her way into her drawers.
Yes, exactly.
It seems like that's what it comes down to for both of y'all.
I'm in it for the art, man.
I'm in it for the fart.
Hit all of us with the disclaimer right now. We all out of line right now.
Allegedly.
Comedy. We need to join comedy for the art.
Am I Hollywood? Is it Hollywood? Because I'm wearing a hat. That's Hollywood. What makes you Hollywood? I mean, for real.
That do-rag.
Hollywood about me.
That do-rag.
That skull cap.
That's Hollywood.
That's a light skin thing.
That's my good hair.
After listening to a lot of the stuff that you guys have said, I think what it really comes down to is just the authenticity of it. So I think that the level of fakeness contributes to the level of Hollywood.
Really,
if you're trying to be somebody you're not, that's different than like somebody being offended by you being yourself.
Because I can be a bitch when I'm poor or rich. So don't say I changed. I'm the same person.
You gotta know your lane though, because you got a lot of cats out here who come to live this LA lifestyle and really don't have the money to do so.
That's true.
And they're talking about, well, look at these peasants on the corner, look at this, but they're struggling to eat.
That's the worst.
That's LA. Leasing your car, everything. Yeah. You know, everything is
living with your mama, but you got 30s.
I was about to say, leasing can be a tax write-off though if you got money, so I wouldn't put it that way.
You don't have to have money to get a tax write-off.
Living in your mama's basement.
Living in your mama's basement.
No, it just got awkward.
Right, it did. It got a little awkward. Team awkward.
Awkward.
You know what I'm saying? Matter of fact, hear my music. We're going to take this short break, and then we're going to come back, and we're going to finish it out strong, man. It's Generation U Radio, man. I want to shout out to our interns real quick. We got Diamond in the building.
Hey, Diamond.
We got Inda in the building. Can I call you Indica? She likes the word indica.
I like that too. Wow. So now
if we can get her to go by Sativa, we in the game. You know what I'm saying?
Round of applause for Indica.
Shout out to DJ Kerr.
Like call her Indica.
Hilarious.
Kerr Angel.
Shout out to White Jane in the building. Indica. Shout out to Hosea in the building, man. It's DJ Orion on the ones and twos. And take us out,
who's
man.
Who's on the phone?
Oh, you know what? Hold. You know what? I'm messing up.
Rewinds.
I'm messing up. I got a homeboy of mine that's been waiting on the phone call for a while. Hey, let's cue him in here real quick. Generation U Radio. What's your name? Where you calling from?
Yo, my name's Jerome Wiggins, man. I'm coming from Washington, D.C.
Hit him with the round of applause. DMV, baby.
In the building.
D.C. Take that MV off.
You're damn right.
D.C.
Hey, man.
Hey,
so,
Jerome. For
those that don't know, you know what I'm saying? I had the homie call in. He manages an artist from the DMV area. Go ahead and shout it out.
Yeah, I'm talking about my girl, Nice. She's going to have a song debut called Pussy Doctor. You know what I'm saying? We're coming from D.C. Just trying to get some love from
Say the name of the
LA,
song again.
You know what I'm saying? Hopefully I get some time to come out here. Never been out there, but hopefully we get some love.
Definitely.
Did you say Pussy Doctor?
The joint's called Pussy Doctor.
Okay. The name of the song?
The record is called Pussy Doctor.
Dr. Pussy, paging Dr. Pussy.
You know what I'm saying? You're going to understand why.
Yeah, play the record, though. The record's dope. So, yeah.
About the only station you can play it on.
That's the only station. Ain't no FCC over here, baby. It's internet radio, baby. It's Generation U Radio, man. Follow us on Twitter and IG at Gen U Radio. Hit this record real quick, man. That's exclusive right there. Hey,
Pussy
hey,
Doctor.
Man, stay on the line, man. We're going to get right back to you. This is Pussy Doctor, man. Take it away.
That's my siren light.
Oh man, hit him with the round of applause.
That shit is different.
Yes. Yeah, shout out to the pussy doctor.
And hit him with the disclaimer at the same time.
How much is that copay, goddammit? What's that copay like?
Right.
Is that,
right.
Is that Obamacare? This talking about.
I'm gonna cover that.
So
for all of our conservative fans out there, we don't fully endorse everything in the record, but at the same time, shout it out to the home team.
Same sex people gonna love that, I guess.
Yeah, there's some people that like it, you know what I'm saying? But saying, you know,
Pussy Doctor better wash her hands.
Some people that do.
Clean under her name.
We make it for you.
What's up?
Pussy Doctor here causing strokes.
Yikes, that's.
I believe we have another guest in the building. I can't see her, but I think she's back there. All right, Trey. Welcome to. Hey, Trey Davenport, celebrity.
Hit her with a round of applause. Oh. She ain't no small thing. Thank you.
You have worked with all types of brands, from music, right, to
PR. Did you say
to
sports?
Yeah, like the type of brand. So yeah, it's music.
How you spell that? PR? How you spell that?
I'm
just joking. Go ahead.
How you spell PR?
Anyway,
spell that.
You can't spell PR. You need the pussy doctor. I don't know.
So you dealt with music artists. You've dealt with athletes. Have you dealt with fashion?
Yeah, fashion authors.
Authors. Mm-hmm. The list goes on. Mm-hmm. Like her rap is. Yes, so
midgets.
Definitely.
Yeah, I'm looking at.
Whatever your brand is, it's safe to say that she can get it taken care of.
All right, she worked with Lil Flip, Corrupt, Tupac, The Outlaws,
Lil Flip, a midget,
Ricky, Rashida, Love and Hip Hop, Atlanta, TV Ones. What is it? The Ultimate Merger.
Housewives.
The Ultimate Merger. Donald Trump's the Ultimate Merger with all.
Okay.
She got a lot of credits.
Where
are
you from? I'm from Detroit.
Uh-oh,
what up, dude?
Oh, God.
Here we go.
Hit Detroit with a round of applause.
Oh, and the D.
We got Detroit. We got Chi. We got Atlanta.
Oh, yeah. This DMV. Is a nice room in here.
Yeah, we in here, huh?
We got LA.
So, Trey, like, as we get into it, I just want to bring you into our topic today. So, I have a question.
Oh, yeah, that's
just
perfect.
Based on the topic. This is the Hollywood show.
Okay.
So, I know that you've dealt with a lot of different personalities in your line of work. So, have you had a client, or have you dealt with a lot of clients who you felt like their personality was too Hollywood to handle?
Absolutely.
Does it happen often?
Wait for you to finish.
Even especially for their status. Did it equal their status?
Beyond their status. Right.
Beyond their status.
Yeah. Everybody be feeling that.
Fire a client because they were beyond too Hollywood.
Mm-hmm. So you will refuse. There is a point where you'll refuse the work.
Absolutely.
And how do you deal with a difficult client? If they're manageable, but like, how would you manage them
if they become too difficult, you mean? Or just
if they're not difficult enough to let go, but you still want to work with them, like, what type of tactics have you found are able to kind of bring them back to reality, kind of?
First of all, I set expectations immediately and in the beginning and ongoing. I do an ongoing gauge and evaluation of how people not only just handle me, but how they handle others,
right,
and how they handle my staff.
Yes.
And the first person that I ever had to let go as a client used to be on the cast of Real Housewives of Atlanta.
Uh-oh.
And really,
you can go ahead and say that name. Go ahead and say that name. I'm
new to LA.
Okay.
And I lived in Atlanta for 12 years, and it was on the day of the BET Awards. Mm. And she treated my staff so bad that
acting Hollywood. Now that would be the perfect example.
I am a reality star, damn it.
Right. I got real talent. Real talent. I'm a reality star.
I said no green gummy bears.
This was right before the Who Gon' Check Me Boo incident.
Uh-oh. So have you had a talk with her?
That was me.
Had you had a talk with her before from a previous incident or anything?
I did try to communicate to her that she had offended some of my staff, and she said that perhaps they were too sensitive.
Oh.
Mm. Yeah.
Okay. Well, don't
she
take
said they were light skinned.
Huh?
Yeah.
They were. I think it's really interesting. Still,
I think it's really interesting how people do things like that, because you're actually building a reputation for yourself in the industry. So you'll get to a point where nobody wants to work.
Yeah, the way
you
treat people is important, man.
Yeah, really.
I look at that even on dates. You know how you talk to a waitress or a waiter, the bartender. All of that is. Yeah.
But so when it comes to, because you actually, I guess you could say the publicist is in charge of the brand, you know, and kind of portraying, just establishing what that person's brand is and portraying that brand to the world.
Can I jump in
real
quick?
So how do you...
I think you just did.
Yeah, it's too late now, nigga. Hey, man.
I think you did just jump in.
Before you hit that point,
I'll try to keep the question
talk
in my mind.
Why ask?
How do you get to the core of what somebody's brand is? Because, you know, that person still has to be authentic to themselves when you're figuring out how to portray that to the world. So how do you figure out who this person is, who this person's brand
is? Well, you just said it. You really need to figure out who they are as an individual to the core and what matters to them.
But you can't place that Hollywood on people if you don't know them yet.
But also, let me piggyback. Right? Do you already get people when they're established as that brand already has it, the bitch or the nerd or whatever, or have you developed the brand with people?
All of the above. I found, though, that I do tend to deal with people who are at the beginning phases of their career. I've just historically have been known to break people. Wow. So as they're developing that brand, so I get to be
can
a
we get
of
a
that.
The hand clap for that?
I was saying that I typically find that I deal with either people who are breaking into the industry and are typically more humble because they're eager to you know get that platform, or people who are re-emerging. I specialize in re-emerging people, and you find that the people who are re-emerging are going to be a little more humble as well.
I understand.
They've had some experiences. Right. They've had some
ups
and downs.
Lost some money.
Some obscurity, lost some money, lost some time.
I don't think you really get to the best that you're going to be as an artist until you have some struggles and stuff like that, because the best artists to me are the ones that's in the struggle.
Yep. Absolutely. I agree.
Now, did you ever find yourself on the talent end, or was this always what the end of you wanted to be on?
I have zero talent. I was born like this.
You got a great voice, though.
Seriously.
I woke up like this.
So, actually, a lot of my friends were very talented in high school, and one of my dearest friends who I accredit to me finding out what I'm supposed to be doing is Nikki Gilbert from Brownstone, R&B Divas. We're both from Detroit, went to the same high school.
Okay.
Nice. I'm at Michigan State. She calls me and like, bitch, oh, can you cuss?
Yeah, you can say anything.
You say, hey, all this time, I just knew you were saying, girl.
It's too late now.
It's too cold in the D. Like, you got to come to L.A. And so I came to California to work with talented friends because they wanted me to speak for them. I need you to talk for me.
Right.
I need you to rep me. I want you to be my manager. I didn't know at the time it was called publicist or PR. I really was just being myself.
Am I sitting next to Olivia Pope?
Interesting.
You got more credits on there.
You are true natural.
Wait, what'd you say? They call you the what?
The fixer.
The fixer.
Like Olivia Pope.
I like that.
Reputation management has been among my specialties.
So what's your favorite part of it? Because you know you have the events and the event escorting, and then you have the
escort.
Oh. You need
define escort.
Do you guys not know?
You need some applicants.
You run an escort service. What?
Oh my gosh.
Hey, sign me up.
What's this?
So clearly none of you guys have publicists, okay?
Right. That can be changed today.
So can you actually break down for us then, actually let's take a step back, the different aspects of working with the brand and working with the client, and what are the different responsibilities?
Oh, wow. Babysitting, ego-stroking, babysitting, really, there's a lot of that. There's a lot of listening involved. Mm-hmm. There's a lot of communicating and understanding who our audience is. I mean, I don't really... I'm not one to really give the textbook answers. I really am a straightforward person.
That's why I want to cuss. You sound like you want to cuss.
She do. She wants it right there.
I feel it. Like, you just wanted that...
I have, get in there with
just
that.
Just get it out.
That's my kind of woman. Issues.
Just say fuck right now.
Cuss issues.
Just say, give me a fuck.
Let it out.
There you go.
I don't fuck with
you. Fuck you. And fuck you. Like you released some gas. You feel better?
So I guess that's a perfect segue, because now fast forward to today, you're doing Crash Course, right?
Absolutely.
So that's your way of teaching.
That's my way of teaching. That's my way of giving back. That's really what I like to do.
Hey.
I've been in the business for almost 20 years, so quite honestly, I've grown a little tired of just, you know, making people famous, making idiots famous in some cases.
All right.
I almost find that the people who deserve it the most, as far as I'm concerned, because they're talented,
don't get it.
They don't get it. Yeah. I find that the people who I'll end up helping or representing or stumbling on, they make it and blow up, really still to this day surprise me and blow my mind, that those are the people who get the shot or who get the look.
Hey, but shout out to the people that put in the work and keep going. All the people out there that's keep going. Don't let that discourage you, man. You can make it. Keep going.
So PR Crash Course is really like my modern day Cliff Notes for people who want to get in the game, or people, all of these young ladies and young men who think all you need is a business card, some stilettos, and Instagram. No offense.
Yeah, some of the dudes be on the stilettos now. It's like hip hop's crazy.
The stilettos, the red bottoms.
Don't even go. They're
Ugg. The Hollywood starter kit.
Ugg boots. Take the Ugg boots off.
This is me saying, hey, let me help you. It's really like a, like they call the dummy's guide.
Right.
It's like a dummy's guide to PR, publicity, and marketing.
And you have a website, or give the info, date.
Yeah, treaday.com.
T-R-A-E.
All day. T-R-E-A.
E-A-E-A.
D-A-Y. My name is Treavion. So okay. Trey is short for Treavion. Right. Treaday.com. Mm-hmm.
Okay.
And you get the crash course is not only classes that I teach that are 4 hours of giving you the insight to the game of PR, marketing, and branding, but it's also a series of books, part of my PR universe.
Yeah, can we bring up that flyer for her so that we can...
Oh,
we can.
And that's what you like to do, huh? You sound compassionate about
yeah,
that.
Yeah.
Oh, I am very passionate about it.
That's good.
You got a great voice, though. Don't ever say you don't have talent, because you got a great
Public speaking. Public speaking, apparently, is your talent, because you're doing the course.
I'm so shy, you think?
You could do this crash course.
Shy? What?
So
I always want to say that.
So is your angle now more so helping people to be able to do it with themselves now? So more so
to either do it themselves or just to offer my perspective, my inside. I have a behind the red carpet, behind the scenes reality.
20 years experience.
Reintro real quick, because we got the flyer on the screen now.
It's called Trey Day's Crash Course, and it's really like a modern day dummy's guide to PR. It's a Cliff Notes for people wanting to break into PR, branding, and marketing. And I give it to you real. I give it to you straight. And it's, you know, ways for you to realize that it's more than just having a business card and some stilettos and an Instagram to be in the game.
And is that in LA or is it online?
It's in Los Angeles right now. I actually teach it in various different cities, but the course that's coming up is actually this weekend and every weekend in January and February.
Oh,
you ever come to Compton?
I love Compton.
I'm not. I was just asking, so I know where not to go.
I ain't never been to Compton. I was just wondering if you went.
I was just there last night.
So I'm down.
You ain't scared of nothing, huh?
No.
I got you.
Yeah. How long have you been doing the course for?
I've been doing the course since last April.
Okay. Mm-hmm. And have you ever taken on any of your students as for representation?
Have I taken on any of my students to represent them? God, no.
No. Okay. So it's a okay.
Well, I won't be there then.
Well,
I've gone on to represent others. Yeah. A lot of my students work for me.
PR.
Okay. So this is okay. I think
you're teaching PR.
I thought you were teaching PR to the talent. So how?
No. I'm teaching the PR one of these. How to actually do it.
We with you.
So this is an industry focus.
Calm down.
It's industry focus. Thank you, but I'm just clearing.
Constant show up there to find representation.
Well, because if I'm listening, that means that there's probably someone out there listening that needed that clarification.
Thank you. So, and actually, there are artists who can take my class, you know, $75 a class, and you get a lot of game that might actually save you from getting jilted by a fake publicist. Or you may not have the budget for your own publicist yet, but you want to know how to put together a press kit. You want to know how to get on the red carpet. Exactly. So my class is actually open for that, so it's not a bad idea.
Hear her with a round of applause.
Yeah.
I like that.
I'm about to say,
Hey, never know. That may be the next one.
let me ask you another question. So you work with high-end clients. Do you ever have people call you Hollywood? And do they, or like people that work for you or whatever, how do you deal with that?
I quickly laugh, LOL. I dispel that because anybody who knows me know I'm the farthest thing from Hollywood.
Right.
I'm not the person that they look for.
So the promo girl who did the liquor at the club, at the Cub Foods, are you going to like let her, you going to PR her?
I didn't hear you.
The girl who's doing the promo liquor over at Costco, you going to let
Costco?
You going to take her over
with the
client.
Hit her with the disclaimer.
That was a loud
I know.
Damn. That damn cricket is a
so
motherfucker.
The point is, she has, you have to have a certain level of something. The promo girl who's doing the liquor at the Costco is not going to be able to be a client.
No, but I know somebody I can refer her to.
Okay, that's good.
There you go.
There's always somebody for somebody.
So you only fuck with top shelf people. You ain't.
Yeah.
I got
absolutely.
You.
Absolutely. In fact, because of that, it's funny you should
know
say
your
that. I've created a product called the PR Mafia because it's really like a syndicate and family of PR people all over who can meet a need on many, many levels.
Right. That's true.
Yeah.
We have
especially if she got a little budget.
Okay.
About herself, as people say.
You work
She was working at Costco, so she should have like a little
something.
You know, a little 25 cents.
Coupons. She got a couple Groupons.
Your money's no good.
That
was
cute.
Patrice was trying to tell me something, but I couldn't hear because he's like, just yell, okay.
No,
Cool.
She hit that wrap it up box.
She said it so shy.
We need to start wrapping up, maybe.
Wrap it up.
Can we dive into the event PR wrote the little bit, just because it seemed like everybody didn't really understand what that really entailed. So what does it mean to escort a client to an event, or to be on the events end of the PR?
On the events end of PR. As the person who's representing a talent that's attending, or the event itself? Both.
You've done both. I'm
absolutely. Yes. Okay, from the event end. If I'm the event planner or working with the event planner, the publicist makes sure that the right people are there.
Right.
The right people could be kids. The right people could be senior citizens. It just depends on the event. But we make sure that you have your A-listers. You make sure that you have your media coming out. You make sure that the paparazzi is buzzing and the cameras are buzzing. And you make sure that there's a recap and there's post-publicity so people know about your event. That's on the event side. And you treat everybody like they are a VIP. Mm-hmm. Everybody. Because you don't know who anybody is.
And who they going to be 5 years from now.
You have no idea.
Who
5 years,
5 minutes
from now. You treat everybody.
Yeah.
Everybody like a VIP.
Have you heard the statement like on the way up, on the way down thing? You heard that? I don't know.
The idea about that? You're going to meet them on the way down. Yeah, absolutely. Yeah.
You on the way up, but you never know when things will flip, basically.
Mm-hmm. Absolutely. Right.
And so when you're representing a client on a red carpet, mm-hmm. what are you looking out for?
You're making sure that their image is represented to the best of their ability. You want to maybe take liquor out of their hand. You want to make sure that they're not smelling like the blunt they just smoked in the vehicle. You want to make sure that they're making eye contact. You may be whispering in their ear a little bit about who a particular person is or who a media person is.
Right.
Making sure that they look presentable, that their lips, unlike Gucci Mane's, are not dry and chapped.
Damn, where's my Carmex?
I used to tell him that. I was Gucci's first publicist.
Your lips are dry.
Wow.
That was a big deal. He never listened to me about that.
Oh. I can imagine he wouldn't listen to much.
Shout
out
to Gucci, man. Shout out to Gucci.
He doesn't make the best decisions.
He doesn't make the best decisions.
He's a good writer.
I'm pre-ice cream cone.
Oh, I'm just saying he doesn't make good decisions.
That wasn't part of
your work. I wasn't sure where.
But pre-ice cream cone. Actually, I'm glad that you mentioned that. So then you're also on the end of image crisis recovery.
Yeah.
So can you speak a little bit about that aspect?
Absolutely. In fact, Gucci Man was my first client who pushed me into the realm of crisis management.
Push you.
No kidding. He did.
Your
on the
lips
eve of
are
him
dry.
Releasing his first album, Trap House.
I remember that.
So yeah. Icy, we're about
that was
to
a
do
good
Rap
single.
City in New York, and we have to actually go have him turn himself in for murder.
Oh, Lord.
Because he really did kill somebody in self-defense. And if it were not for a strong PR campaign, crisis management campaign, getting those people out, giving those tips.
A chapstick deal.
if it weren't for crisis management and being able to deal with the community and the audience and get people engaged and involved, DeKalb County Sheriff would never have let that man go.
Oh, yeah, in DeKalb? Yeah. Oh, yeah, nah.
In Georgia.
Think CarMax, not murder.
So she doubles as an attorney. If you needed to be at the court, she had an attorney.
Vaseline.
But they interact with those people. They interact with the attorneys.
All right, let's run this out real quick. I have one little in the black. We don't have a lot of time for it, but I'm going to do one of my little in the black segments, you guys. How you doing? This week we had a great, our president spoke, State of the Union address.
Yes.
And I just loved his quote, "I have no more campaigns to run because I won both of them."
Yeah.
So, hit him with a round of applause.
Mm-hmm. Shout
all
out.
These haters out there.
Shout out to the light skin nation.
Hating on him. The economy's better. There's more jobs. What you're going, you can't blame him when it's bad and not blame
healthcare
him when it's good.
Healthcare is on the rise.
Yeah. So I just wanted to end on that. This was a great show. What do you think, Scotty?
Hey, man, I'm glad that we got fam in the building, man. Yeah. I'm just happy about that shit, you know what I'm saying? For real.
Let's go around the room and give everybody RT. What's your social media?
You can look me up on Twitter, Facebook, YouTube, whatever, all types of stuff, at RT Steckel. So just be on the lookout for me.
Sounds
and make sure you check in February 2nd on Sirius Foxhole 96.
Yes.
8 a.m. to 12
Shout
p.m. on the West Coast.
Okay. That's my big
Thank
homie.
You.
Shout
Coming
out to
through.
Hit a round of applause J.Keene, for the Fox.
Let's Thank you. Keep it rolling.
My Facebook is J.Keene, the comedian. Instagram, the same thing. Look for me. I'm about to get back out here, you know what I mean? Get my feedback wet, get back on the scene, because I'm funny than a motherfucker.
All right.
And I'm just, you know what I mean?
Tell him, man. Tell him, man.
No. I told me that. Shit, God told me that when I was born, you feel me? But no. I'm about to get back on the scene because I look at comedy from a different perspective now. I'm not in competition trying to be the best comedian. I'm healing people through my laughter and through my jokes. So that's how I'm going to look at it, and that's how I'm going to take it.
Oh, that's congratulations on that.
Yeah. Sure, thanks.
Trey Davenport.
Hey, it's Trey Davenport. I thank you for letting me come on and talk about my PR
campaign.
Thank
you.
Thank you for joining us.
It's my pleasure. I'm also one of three brand masters on a 10-city brand master tour that kicks off in Houston in February. And I'm participating in the Comics Who Rock convention. We'd love to get you involved in that.
There you go.
I'm with you.
Yeah, that'd be great. I'm teaching another PR class for comics who actually need to
with Hope Flood.
To help. Yeah, with Hope Flood. Yeah, exactly. With Hope Flood. I can be found at Trey Davenport on all social media platforms. Trey is T-R-E-A Davenport, D-A-V-E-N-P-O-R-T, or TreyDay.com.
And don't forget about her classes.
Yeah,
this Saturday,
I was going to say, when you got stuff coming up, or if you know, when you have that tour, if you let them know, we'll welcome anybody that you want to refer.
I'd love to bring in some of my clients.
Baltimore,
all kind of great people.
Thank you.
Sex telephone operator, your voice is amazing.
Got a microphone over there?
It's Trey Day Davenport.
Let's talk about it.
How's it going? It's DJ Orion. Go to www.orionmusic.com and listen to some live mixes and see some of my original productions.
All right.
Shout out to DJ Orion on the ones and twos. Thanks for coming out, man. We appreciate you.
Thank you.
Welcome. Damn right. I want to get Diamond and Karen and Ender to get on the mic real quick. I want to hear y'all shout this stuff out.
It's some of our interns,
hey
guys.
This is Indica Calavoda with a K. Have a great weekend.
Oh, thank
Indica.
You.
Indica. K.
She's so graceful, ain't she?
Isn't she?
Diamond.
Come on, Diamond. Karen, you too. Karen, don't sit. Don't hide behind. I'm going to get everybody. Jay, you about to be on too.
Y'all next show.
All right.
Thank you, Diamond.
So bad.
Our DJ, Kara Angel. She's not on the ones and twos today, but she's in the house.
What's up, everybody? It's DJ Kara Angel. You can check me out on SoundCloud at soundcloud.com/
I like that voice.
DJ.
She got a nice voice.
I do too.
Kara
Angel. I felt some type of way when she said
that. And we got one more DJ. We got one more DJ.
We need wiggle commanding.
We're going to talk to
DJ White J. We got diversity in the building.
Yeah. That's what's up. Well, anyway, I just wanted to say I love that Obama response also
right.
to the Republican
and
Party.
You gotta do that because we were
booing
here.
Him, and he looked at them right in the face and said, I know because I
you
want
to start
both
with Obama. It's cool.
What's up? You'll hear me on this.
It was like giving a finger.
Man.
Yeah.
That was dope. It was dope.
Priceless.
Who else? Hey, Alicia.
I called Jay-Z for a line, and Jay-Z was like, say this.
Shout out to Alicia, my production team, Alicia and Patrice in the background.
Hey.
Thank you, guys.
Everybody, shout out to Hosea. Holding it down on photography.
Holding it down.
Ginger Surprise. Check them out. Check out that Ginger Surprise.
.com. GingerSurprise.com.
I'm delicious. Surprised you didn't bring any.
He did
bring some. He's been drinking it all show. You know what I'm saying? Hey, and we got LaRon. We got the JJE in the building. Come on here and tell the people where you going to be at.
What's up, everybody? This is LP from the Hip Hop Show. Tune in on Tuesday nights. We're going to have Super Kelly Everything as a guest. It's a 7-man group. It's 4 versus 7. It's like a tag team match, but it's cool.
He got it.
Well, I got this. Me and my team got this.
You got your he got his cadence.
And watch the hip hop.
Hit him with the round of applause. He just hit him. He hit a good interview, man. He's been working on that.
Said that shit.
Hey, damn right, man.
He's been working on his drops.
All right, man.
Don't drop the mic.
Hilarious, man. Shout out to.
I didn't get y'all. Go ahead. I can't get that.
Shout out to Team Light Skin or In the Black. One of the two.
What's up, you guys? Courtney Black. You can catch me.
She hate when people interrupt her, nigga. Just let her go.
Slap.
I got hands and shit all in front of me. What's up, you guys? It's Friday. I'm going to get rid of these niggas and see you next Friday. CourtneyBlackComedy.com. Check me out. Check my show. You can find me on Twitter at Miss Courtney Black. That's MS Courtney Black. Thank you. Have a great weekend. Be safe.
There you go. I like that.
Go
like
light skin.
That shit was cute. Go ahead, man.
Go light skin. I don't even get In the Black credits. That's right. What's up.
We got all shades accounted for, you know.
So it's your boy William Basham. You know, go Seahawk Nation. We just made it to the Super Bowl. Also,
your face.
Hey, that was a good game.
Covering my face.
That was a good game.
Sometimes it doesn't always need to be singing. I'm too.
That was one of the best football games I've seen in years.
That game was great.
That was a great game.
It was awesome. But you can find me on Instagram and Twitter at _WilliamB1 if you want to watch some funny stuff, some skits. I'm always doing them. So yeah.
Damn right, man.
And they are funny.
Yeah, man.
They are funny.
He's hilarious, man. Check him out. He's got a lot of roles.
Some films, some plays. I got some stuff.
He got a lot of roles
acting right now. So yeah.
Why you bullshit?
Yeah.
Hey, man, I'm going to go ahead and take it out like that, man. If you want to follow me, go on Instagram, Scotty Trippin, SCOTTIETRIPN.
I
just felt like I wanted to smooth it out real quick.
He's saving the best for last.
It's okay. I'm just Melanie, okay. You know, I'm nobody, but you know, I'm here. And
you're somebody, baby. You're somebody.
Don't be like that.
Stop back in Hollywood.
I'm nobody.
Round of applause.
Yeah.
right. Hollywood at its finest, right? All right. And you can find me on Facebook and Twitter at Melanie C. Eke, and Eke spelled E-K-E, and on Instagram at Melanie Chantel with a C. Thank you, Scott. Yep.
And you can find her at the Zen Lounge on Sundays.
Yes.
We're very proud of you.
Oh, yes.
Okay. I'm going to get out there someday, I swear.
One day.
I'll be there one day. You know what I'm saying?
What's going on?
I won't hold my breath, though.
You'll catch me. She does some music. Sometimes they have comedy.
Sunday sessions.
Sessions.
Every Sunday, there's a different session. It may be live music. It may be comedy. Wow. It may be a game night. It's at Zen
Poetry?
Lounge.
You got poetry?
Game night?
No poetry?
We have done poetry, though. We don't do it often, but
I don't do it. I was just asking because you didn't say poetry.
We got a space tournament coming up.
That's what I'm saying.
It's all in there. But anyway, Sunday Zen Lounge.
Comedy was good.
Comedy was good.
Y'all might want to do it.
Courtney hit the stage one time before, so
it's a nice room.
Would like to grace our stage with your presence.
Team Awkward. Y'all niggas sound it's a lot of energy in here right now.
It's time to try,
man. We're going to keep it.
This can't go to waste.
Shout out to RT and J.Keene in the building. We appreciate y'all coming out, man.
Thank you, guys.
Damn right. Generation U Radio, man. Reality Radio. Fridays at 6 o'clock, RMC on air. If you get a chance, check us out on YouTube and all that. If you don't remember anything else, remember these three things, man. Support the people, support the art, support the movement, man.
Do that.
Yee!
Sitting in the studio, just trying to get to you, babe. But the song's so fucking dope, girl, it's hard not for me to play.